And a very, very warm welcome to church today. My name is Pete. I'm the pastor of Winscombe Church. I'll be leading our service, and then I'll be preaching a bit later on in the morning. If you're here for the first time today, a special welcome to you. Our prayer is that you meet with God here. This is first day of the week. It's Resurrection Day, the day we celebrate Jesus rose from the dead. And we're here to meet with him, the living Lord and God. Have him speak into our lives. And pray to him and sing our praises to him. A few notices as we start. First of all, to say we're looking for a bit more help with our packaway. This is a great opportunity to have a workout after church for about 20 minutes, just to kind of pack stuff away, get the room back in order. If you'd like to serve in that way, do come and speak to myself or Sarah, and we'd love to kind of put you on a team to help with that. There's a prayer meeting this afternoon for the suffering church around the world at 4 o'clock today. If you're on our mailing list, you'll have had an email with details for that. Our prayer meeting on Tuesday runs as normal at 12:30, a chance to pray for our church family, pray for the world. Life groups meet as normal this week, and we'll be picking up on this morning's message this week as we think about assurance in 1 John this morning. Now, tomorrow is Halloween, and we have a light party at Barnes Road. We want to celebrate that Jesus wins, and that he is good, as opposed to that evil wins, and celebrating violence and evil things. So, great opportunity to invite families along to this, 5 until 6:30, tomorrow at Barnes Road. Come along, it'll be a great time. Next Sunday at 10 o'clock, we have a communion service. Often when we have communion or the third Sunday in the month, it's part of our main meeting. This communion once a month on a first Sunday is a chance to have a bit more leisurely time, half an hour, just celebrating the Lord's Supper, worshiping together. Do join us next Sunday at 10 o'clock. Now, a date for your diary, 17th of November, Thursday evening, we have what we call a big pray. Starts with refreshments, but it does what it says on the tin. We're going to pray together. So we'd love you to join us for that. We've also got Alan Knowles from Cape Town with us on that day, and he'll be doing a short devotional and sharing about his work. He's one of our mission partners training church leaders there in Cape Town. So if you put that date in your diary, a great chance to pray together. We're praying particularly about our Christmas events this year as well for the evening. A couple of dates for your diary there, Craft Evening and Curry Night are coming up. We'll be getting publicity out for them very soon, but great events to invite people along to in the lead up to Christmas. Well, we're going to pray. Why don't we stand and in the Lord's presence, and we're going to pray together, and then we're going to sing a couple of songs together as well. Let me read from just a couple of verses that we're going to be looking at this morning to set the tone for our time together. We're thinking about how do we know the truth this morning. And the Apostle John writes this: "This is how we know that we belong to the truth and how we set our hearts at rest in his presence. If our hearts condemn us, we know that God is greater than our hearts and he knows everything." Lord God, you know the state of each of our hearts this morning. You know whether we feel condemned here this morning, and we pray that you'd help us to come to you and know your love, your grace, your forgiveness, flooding our hearts and our lives as we come to you and lay everything before you, give our lives afresh to you. Lord Jesus, we thank you that on this first day of the week, you beat death, you rose from the dead, you conquered the powers of hell, and we thank you that we can know you today. Would you, by your Spirit, speak into our lives and hearts this morning, that praise and worship might go to you, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to start by singing a great song. I haven't sung this for a while. It's a prayer. Lord, I come to you, and it's praying, Lord, would you change my heart? Let's sing together.
flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I count it all the weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away.
I don't know if that describes your week this week, that you've soared with God in your relationship with God. You've known his spirit leading you on in your life. Maybe that's a far cry from what's been your experience this week. I don't know. Do you know, one of the ways that we do that, the way that we look to the Lord for his strength, is by focusing on the great things he's done for us in our lives. And as we look back to the cross and his resurrection. And this next song celebrates that, the great things that God has done for us. Let's give thanks to him. And let's sing great things.
Come, let us worship our King. Bow at his feet, he has done great things. See what our Savior has done. See how his love overcomes. He has done great things. He has done great things. Oh, hero of heaven, you come. Chain.
Well, please sit down. And children, do you want to come to the front? And Sarah is going to speak to you this morning.
Good morning, everybody. Do come and grab a seat down here. It's lovely to see you. Brilliant. Good job. Can you give me a cheesy smile if you've had a good half term? Yeah, there are. I was going to say there's some cheesy smiles down here. There are a few cheesy smiles actually in the adults as well, which is brilliant. I'm glad you've had a good half term. Fantastic. Now I've got some questions for you. And the answer is what you think, but I want just two things. Okay? So you've got to think of two things. So the first question is, if you could have an ice cream and you could have two scoops of two different flavors, what two flavors would you choose? Have a think. What two flavors would you choose? Let's see if this is on. Right. James, what two flavors would you choose?
Just chocolate.
Okay, just chocolate. I need another. What would you put with your chocolate?
Strawberry.
Oh, I thought you were going to say chocolate chip, which would have been close. Well done. So chocolate and strawberry over here, Danny.
Chocolate chip and strawberry.
Oh, very similar. Chocolate chip and strawberry. Thank you, Florrie.
Strawberry and salted caramel.
Oh, classy. One more, Finn.
Robot flavour and banana flavour.
Robot flavour is not a flavour I've come across yet, but I'm sure it goes really well with banana. Fantastic. Brilliant. Okay, next. Two things. Two colours that go together well that you think, oh, I really like those two colours together. Yeah.
Pink and yellow.
Pink and yellow. Great. I like it. Yeah.
Red and yellow.
Red and yellow. Yellow is the top colour at the moment. Yeah, Aaron.
Red and blue.
Red and blue. Red, yellow, blue. We'll do one more. Yeah, what do you like?
Green and blue.
Green and blue. Some good colours. Everyone's got a different kind of idea of what they like, don't they? Fantastic. What about you could have two toppings on a pizza? What two toppings would you choose? Many, many hands have gone up over here. Right, Arthur, what would you choose?
Pepperoni and barbecue sauce.
Pepperoni and barbecue sauce. A few nods, Jamie.
Cheese and tomato.
Cheese and tomato. I think that's a good, safe one. What would you think,
Bea? Cheese and pepperoni.
Cheese and pepperoni. All sorts. You can tell me later, those of you who didn't get a chance to answer that. Two good things that go together. Do you know, in the Bible, The writers of the Bible have lots and lots and lots of things that they tell us about what it means to be a Christian. That is what it means to be a follower of Jesus. Now, there are lots of pizza toppings, lots of colours, lots of ice cream flavours, but you chose just two. And in the book that the adults are going to hear from a bit later on that we've been reading together, in the book of 1 John, it's a letter that John was writing to believers in Jesus, those who are following Jesus. And he picks out, there are lots of things he could have picked, but he picks out two things that he thinks are really important about what it means to be a Christian, a follower of Jesus. Should we have a look and see what they are? This is what he writes. It's one verse, and he writes this in his letter. This is God's command, to believe in the name of his son, Jesus Christ, and to love one another as he commanded us. Did you spot the two things? The first one is to believe in the name of his son, Jesus. That is basically a way of saying what it means to trust in Jesus and his death on the cross for us. And that by trusting him, knowing, putting our trust in him and following him, knowing that we're forgiven, our sins have been forgiven, and that we're made right with God. And that's basically what it means to be a Christian, to be a believer, is to believe in the name of Jesus. Did you spot the second one? To love one another as he commanded us. The second one is really an outworking. It's a result of what it means to love Jesus and to trust Jesus and to believe in his name. And that is that Christians love other Christians, other brothers and sisters in Jesus. Now, I wonder what that might look like for us. It might be that we want to help somebody or support somebody or really care for somebody or to draw alongside and get to know somebody well and to really help them. That might be a way of loving other believers, other Christians. And maybe even in junior church, as you go out in a moment, you might think, how can I love the other people in my group? How can I love them? And how can I help them too to believe in the name of Jesus? And how can I do that for myself too? Because that's our prayer for all of you, that you will come, if you haven't already, to believe in the name of Jesus. Should we pray? Should we say a prayer? Let's close our eyes and say a prayer. Dear God, thank you for these two beautiful things that John wrote in this letter. Thank you for Jesus, and we pray that you'd help each one of us to believe in his name. We thank you for other believers, and we pray that you'd help us to love them well. And Father, we thank you for junior church, and we pray that you'd help us to have a great time learning more about what it means to believe in the name of Jesus, and you might give us opportunities to love each other well there too. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Right, it is now time for junior church. So what you need to do is we're just going to go out really gently and slowly and carefully down to the far end, have a lovely time, and we look forward to seeing you when you get back. Good to see you all.
And Discovery, you're staying with us this morning. If you want a sermon, a sheet to make notes on for your sermon, there's those at the back as well. You can grab those now if you like. Well, we're going to pray together. And as we pray this morning, as you'll be aware, we try and pray every week for one of our mission partners. Jack is well known to us. He's one of our church members and is in Thailand and working there in Chiang Mai. In the School of Promise there, teaching English, but sharing the gospel there with children, but also in the local market there as well. And Jack has a real passion to take the gospel to an area called Isan, which is an area that's very unreached with the gospel. So we're going to pray for him particularly this morning. Let's pray. Psalm 100 says, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God.